You're listening to Winnipeg's Classic 107. My name is Simon Rusnak. Seanne Buenafe is an experienced performer at the local right up to international levels and has been turning heads and impressing audiences for years now, which is no small feat given his age. Having just turned 17, the award-winning pianist presents a benefit recital on October 17th in support of Kids Help Phone. It is my pleasure to welcome back Seanne to air. Hello. Great to have you back here on Winnipeg's Classic 107, Seanne.
Yes, thank you for having me.
So before we get to your playing and the music that you've programmed for this concert, as I mentioned in the intro, this is a benefit concert and it goes towards Kids Help Phone. Can you start off by telling us why the work that they do is important to you?
Yeah, for sure. So the recital is in support of Kids Help Phone, which is a national 24/7 e-mental health service that gives young Canadians the essential support that they need in times of crisis. They can connect you with professionals through a simple phone call or a text, and they offer advice on their website and social media pages on how to keep yourself mentally healthy, especially during the pandemic. The mental health struggles teens have and the mental health struggles we've all faced have unfortunately increased, but Kids Help Phone has always remained a beacon of sorts of free and accessible e-mental health support. So this cause is very important and significantly close to my heart, as I had a friend who had taken their own life earlier this year in March. They were very close to me and I'm holding the recital in their honor. Overall, my hope is that by raising money for Kids Help Phone and spreading awareness of the importance of mental health, you know, especially with this pandemic that seems like it's never gonna end and is ever changing, we can strive to ensure that every teen, every young person suffering with mental crises will have the free and accessible mental health support that they deserve.
You know, Seanne, let me just start off by saying, you know, I'm so sorry to hear about the passing of your dear friend. I mean, that's got to be really hard.
Mm-hmm. It was definitely very hard the first few weeks, you know, transitioning back into normal life, still sort of lingering with that emotion. But I've learned to sort of, you know, honor their legacy and use sort of the good that they had spread when they were alive as a way to spread awareness of these important causes such as mental health. So, you know, it's kind of like looking at it in a positive light, although that's not really the words I'd like to use. It's sort of like, you know, taking this situation and spreading awareness about something that is very important, not only for people like me, but for people all over.
Yeah, you know, to me, it seems almost like you're taking a tragedy and turning it into almost like an opportunity to learn more about the importance of mental health, right? And so often people suffer in silence, and Kids Help Phone, like you say, gives children and youth the opportunity to reach out and receive the support that they so need. So thank you for spreading the word while, like you say, honoring the memory of your good friend. I am curious, you've given plenty of performances over the years. Going into this one, does it somehow feel different at all being a benefit concert in honor of your friend rather than something like a year-end recital or something like that?
There's definitely factors that are different. Like, this is really the very first time I've headlined a concert of my own with the help of my incredible piano teacher, Ms. Jacqueline Riz, who will also be accompanying me in the second half of this show. We're performing Rhapsody on a Theme of Paganini by Sergei Rachmaninoff, one of the greatest piano concertos ever. In terms of what's different, it's very, there's a lot of planning that goes into it. There's a lot of behind the scenes work. My mom, Miss Riz, they've been working back and forth, you know, around the clock, just ensuring that everything goes well. From my end, it's obviously, you know, practice, ensuring that I give a performance that is worthy of, you know, this cause and worthy of the proceeds that are coming in, which it's incredible how many people are supporting. I'm really grateful for all the support that I've been receiving so far. I'm very excited for the concert to take place, and I feel like it's going to be very, 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 very exciting.
And I'm sure you're gonna play very, very well. Can you tell us a little bit, you kind of alluded to the program. Can you tell us a little bit more about the composers that are on the program?
For sure, yeah. So I'll be performing a prelude and fugue in F major from the Well-Tempered Clavier by J.S. Bach, a very prolific Baroque composer. He changed the face of music. I will also be performing Beethoven's Waldstein Sonata. As many of us know, Beethoven went deaf later on in his life, but still composed music. I find he's one of the biggest inspirations for me personally, with that sort of perseverance and determination that he composed even as he was going deaf. I'm also going to be performing a very cool contemporary piece called In Memoriam to the Victims of Chernobyl by Canadian composer Larissa Kuzmenko, who currently, I believe, works at the University of Toronto, I think in the Faculty of Composition or something like that. Mm-hmm. And finally, as I said before, I'm performing Sergei Rachmaninoff's famous Rhapsody on the theme of Paganini, one of the greatest Russian composers of all time. Such colorful music, such interesting harmony. There's lots and lots and lots of things in this concerto that just, it's immaculate.
Immaculate is a great word for it. You know, there's some familiar names in there, Bach and Beethoven, and then the Kuzmenko, which you talked about a few months ago when you were performing ahead of the Virtuosi Side by Side online concert. Can you tell us a little bit more about the big beefy work that is here? I mean, the Beethoven is no walk in the park in terms of the Waldstein, but I want to talk a little bit more about this Immaculate Rhapsody on a Theme by Paganini. It is just a huge piece of music, isn't it?
Oh, for sure. It's a behemoth of a piece. Not only in terms of, well, obviously length, but also in terms of content. What I believe is that the concerto itself tells a story, and the story is based on, you know, esteemed violinist Niccolo Paganini. He's here, he plays very well, he plays lots of, you know, very technically challenging pieces as if, you know, they're just very easy to him. And so at the time that he was so distinguished, many people had believed that he had sold his soul to the devil. And we hear this in the piece around the seventh variation in or something like that, where the Caprice melody that the piece is based around, which was written by Paganini, mm-hmm. it's intertwined with the Dies Irae plain chant, which in history, it's been used to represent, you know, it's been used at funerals, it's been used to represent the devil, in horror movies even, it's been used in, you know, Stephen King's The Shining, you'll hear it in there. So it gets intertwined with this Dies Irae, like Gregorian chant that kind of represents the devil tempting him and saying, you know, sell your soul for the talent, the fame, the money. And, you know, he gets carried away into this life of luxury, and before he realizes it's too late, he starts to regret his decision. He starts to run away from the devil, even when he knows that, you know, this deal is eternal. He can never run away from it. So I believe that this piece, it's one of those great storytelling pieces where, like, you can hear Paganini running away from the devil. You can hear the devil tempting him to, you know, sell your soul. He's very menacing, even with, you know, even with just two pianos, you'll be able to hear all of those different elements work together.
Yeah, I mean, it really is programmatic music. And like you say, this Rhapsody on a Theme, a very famous theme by Paganini, the last of his 24 caprices. And then what Rachmaninoff does with that theme in the 24 variations, I mean, it is a trip in and of itself. And of course, this a work for piano plus orchestra. Originally, you'll be performing alongside your piano teacher, right? In a version for two pianos.
Yes. We've been rehearsing it like crazy just to get everything together, obviously. You know, I've been working on this piece, I believe, for a few years now. I think at this rate, I probably know it like the back of my own hand. But it is such a fun piece. It is such an incredible work to just, you know, to listen to it. Playing it is a huge accomplishment for my piano teacher and I. So, you know, having the opportunity to just listen to it, you'll be able to hear so much good music. So yes, stay tuned for that.
Yeah. So much great music, and also for such a great cause. Seanne, you know, I want to thank you so much for taking the time to chat with me today about the benefit concert that you've got going on in a few weeks' time. I'm sure it's going to be practice right up until the lights come on, right?
Definitely.
Well, thanks so much for taking the time today, Seanne.
Thank you for having me again.